Simon. I'm so glad you made it to the launch. After all, your stories about the other worlds you've seen inspired me to write this book. A trip to Eileen Moore? Wow, thanks. I've always dreamed of seeing it myself. It's so mysterious. It's the perfect place to get some inspiration. In 1900, three of the lighthouse keepers at Eileen Moore disappeared. Then last year, another went missing. None of them were ever found. It's rumored that the lighthouse has magical origins. I just can't wait to gather information for my new book. Did you see that strange light? I wonder what it is. We have to get in there. This could be a perfect opening for my new story. Do you mind if I dictate some info with my recorder? I've received lots of letters from my readers about the mysterious light coming from Eileen Moore's lighthouse. I have a theory that the lighthouse is a portal to another world, so I came here to compile whatever I can find out for a new book. We must find a way to get into the lighthouse. Here, maybe my notes will be useful. I need to look for a new cassette for my recorder. Please, find a way into the lighthouse while I prepare my recorder. Yes! You got it open! Let's go. See that? That mysterious light was coming from that phoenix. Let's see what's up there. I think the light from the phoenix egg could open the portal, but it's cracked. Maybe there's another one.
Thank you. Welcome to Aerdus. I'm Juari, the Windwatcher. No seekers have visited our world for many centuries. Your friend is hurt. Please, find something to bring her around. Hurry, the magic's effects can be deadly.
Where are we? Is this a parallel world? This is definitely going in the book.
This is Aerdus, the world of air and lightness. A world where the inhabitants can all fly. This portal connects Aerdus to other worlds, including yours. But something is wrong. It brings people here against their will. Briel, the Lord of the Firstborns, did something to the portal to lure in humans. He wants to study you and invade your world. That's why he attacked you when you arrived. It's not safe here. We must go to the port. A soaring ship will take us to my house. Let's hurry before Briel returns with more guards. You can't fly like me. But you can use the wind portals. They can transport you between the floating islands. Here, this will activate the wind portal. I'll go scout Port Aerdus to make sure it's safe.
Again, Juori. Must you meddle in my plans? Is this how you repay everything the Firstborns have done for Aerdus? We shared our technology, and we protected you from the flying fish. Aerdus would have died without our alliance. You should show more gratitude. Another human? I didn't expect two of you. You're a Seeker, aren't you? I can't have you summoning the Seeker Council, but I need your friend to help my army invade your world. This should take care of you.
Please, help me. I can't hold this monster for long.
Didn't expect this betrayal from Origin, the world who offered us the Alliance. The Firstborns who inhabit Origin are quite intellectual. But progress comes at a cost, and pollution began to take over their world. The harvest suffered, and fish and seahorses died from the waste in their rivers and seas. Origin had to ally with two other worlds. Aertus shared our clean water, and Oasis provided fruit in exchange for technological artifacts. Origin, for centuries, the Firstborn lured humans in to study them, with the Ilian Moor lighthouse and magic spheres. Now Brielle is going to use your friend to sail into the human world. We must repair my ship and follow Brielle to save your friend. Here, take this amulet to get on the ship. please, find a new...
So, you and the human survived. How stupid of you, Juori. After all my years of study, I've learned that humans are dangerous. All they do is kill each other and ruin their planet.
You're only saying that to justify an invasion. Your own brilliant mind ruined Origin, and now you're depleting the other worlds to save it. This can't go on.
You were in love with a human, but he left you for his own precious world. Yet you still believe in these creatures? You're hopeless, Juori, and I'm tired of you.
Please, help me put out the fire.
We are all tired of Brielle's sick game. He's bent all of the worlds to his will by making us dependent on his technology. It's time to stop him. We must get to the portal in the Garden of Constellations to reach Origin. But the passage is blocked. Could you clear it? I need to find the books about activating the portal. Feel free to explore my house for anything you need. You did it. Excellent. And I found the book I needed to activate the portal. It says that we should adjust the control mechanism before creating a teleportation funnel, but some buttons are missing. Please, find the buttons and help me get the portal working.
Thank you.
Origin doesn't like unwelcome visitors. Kill them.
Marcus? Why? My love.
I'll handle this.
I'm wounded. Please find something to heal the wound. Thank you. That will help for now. But I'm in a lot of pain. Find the Phoenix Tear, an artifact that can heal terrible injuries in minutes. People from Origin have studied phoenixes and learned that if a phoenix can tell that your intentions are true, it may give you a pure teardrop. I am not well enough to go with you, but take this map. It'll help you reach the valley. Thank you. I can't believe Marcus is helping Brielle. Something must be wrong. We were so in love. Brielle will pay for whatever he's done to him. My friend from Oasis wants to start a rebellion. Brielle is so desperate to save his world that he will destroy others, including yours. The portal to Oasis is on another island, but first, we must go through the Iron Woods. Here, take this. I found it nearby. We must be quiet, so we don't disturb the inhabitants. We will be safe once we cross the dead meadow. Then, we'll find the portal that leads to the oasis.
Ooh. Please, have mercy. My name is Matt. Many firstborns don't agree with Briel, but they're afraid to defy him. We're forced into serving a hateful leader, but you must hurry. The Guardians will be here soon.
Don't worry, I'll handle this. Find my friend Kirai. Go to the Firstborn's world with her, and stop Brielle.
I am Malada. I haven't seen people in this world in a long time. You must have come to find Kirai. I'd help you, but I'm starving. I must eat something soon. There's a barn nearby, but the passage is blocked. Let's go there first, and I'll help you once I've eaten.
Thank you. Now please climb on my back, and we'll be off.
I'm Karai, Juwori's friend. Brielle has taken so much food from our world that even the creatures are starving. Amber the Fox has gathered an army, and I'd like her to join us. Please talk to her. As the Seeker, I know she'll listen to you. I know how to stop Brielle. We'll need to get to the top of Sky's Tower, but I can't leave Oasis with the forest occupied by wolves. Go talk to Amber while I prepare the portal to the tower. Good luck!
I'm sorry I was so cruel before. Hunger can make one do terrible things. But I'm ready to make amends and join your fight.
Thank you for your help. Amber's troops will distract the guards while we get inside as quickly as possible.
Thank you. Your attempt to stop us will be in vain. All of the worlds will suffer when Brielle learns of your rebellion.
Remove the collar, quickly!
Oh, thank you. My memory's a bit fuzzy, but I think Brielle used me to make Jury believe that humans are wicked in order to justify taking our water. It won't be easy to get to the top, but I have a plan. I'll pretend I'm still under Brielle's control while Kirai distracts the guards. You should repair the elevator in the meantime, so we can rescue Naomi. I'll look at the control panel. Take this. It might be handy.
Thank you.
please, be careful. Briel has access to advanced technology, so try to avoid trouble.
Human world is almost mine. Nothing can stop me now.
I knew you'd come. Listen, I learned about a powerful weapon that can defeat Brayel. The blueprint is hidden somewhere around here. Let's look around. That's it! That's the weapon! We need to find it and power it up.
Thank you.
you. And of course, thank you to my husband Simon for the adventure of a lifetime.
See? Not all humans are dangerous. They're just naturally curious.